Hey, how's everybody doing? I just wanted to add this video in with the current series that I'm running. This is a spare PO6 board. I'm going to be doing a VTEC conversion to it and a chipping conversion. And I wanted to show why it's important to replace the capacitors and what other types of damages it can cause. While you're in there, or if the capacitor goes bad. So this capacitor here, which is C18, capacitor 18, it's one of the small capacitors. If you see, and I'll get it closer for you guys, it burnt out in the bottom there, and it leaked the electrolyte that's in there. It's sort of like a mini battery, just kind of holds a charge in there, 10 volts. And it's used for various different parts of the ECU. Well, at 30 years old, these things are getting taxed. These are newer models have come out that are higher heat resistance. So what happens when one of these leaks is you end up getting corrosion and all down on the board down there. And what happened is it leaked and it made this transistor here either catch fire or come loose or whatever it did to it. But let me get that closer for you. But if you see, it ended up burning this one out at the legs and basically caused that part of the board to fry. There's multiple other capacitors leaking on here. So this board's going to need a full capacitor replacement, and this will be the board that I show the video of the capacitor replacement on. Included in the chipping video. Careful thing to look at is when you're looking at these boards here, this is a printed circuit board, so I'm not really concerned about the front here. You see all that corrosion is? Not really concerned about this. What I'm concerned about is the back of the board, where the circuit paths are. So there, there, and there, and there, and there. As you can see, the circuit paths are clear on this side. Less a little dust there from me cleaning it. Yeah, brush that off real quick. Alright. So the clear coating you see is like a protective urethane coating they put on the PCB boards. It's always good to put it back when you're done. But yeah, if you can see, the actual circuit paths in the back of the board are okay. You flip it around at the front, it looks like it's screwed, but it's not. This is just the printed side where the components would go, so I care less about this side. Hopefully this ECU still works. This will be a spare one that I use for testing. But yeah, those are some things to look out for. If you look right there, you see that one. That one's starting to leak, so that's... I don't even know what one that is. Doesn't say. There's your main capacitor, your C14. That one is usually always replaced. And you see that's the original one. It's old. C15 looks okay, but that one's going to get gone. C40 is looking okay, but we're going to get rid of that one as well. And I got to put that new transistor in. So, other than that, I mean, those are the main things you really got to replace are these capacitors on here. You don't want these to leak on the board. So, and if you look here, I'm starting to get some leakage down here. They're starting to go bad, so we'll get rid of C24 and C21 as well. And once I get them installed, we'll see if the ECU works. But yeah, I wanted to point that out, that the front of the board is not a big deal. It's the back of the board that you're worried about. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.